people. So in this video, I'm going to break down why it's so hard for some of you to let go of hurtful experiences or just let go of things in general, and how you can easily get the process started so that you can finally get some forward motion in your life. So we're gonna cover a few things. Why it's so hard to let go, you know, how to evaluate your attachment to the thing that you're having a hard time letting go of. In other words, your relationship to that thing. And about midway through the video, I'm also gonna give you some questions to ask yourself so that you can get to the bottom of why you're not letting go. And by implementing these small steps, it's gonna be a game changer to your mindset and how you approach the things that are holding you back. I promise you, if you practice this, you'll have a greater understanding of yourself and the situation, which then will give you the momentum to begin the process of letting go. Then what's really left is just practicing, right? I always teach my clients in what micro ways can they practice the things that are hard for them in the smallest way possible. And I'll do a video about that later and what that technique is, because you do get better. You get better at practicing the hard stuff. Now, I know some of you might be saying, okay, you know, this whole letting go thing is easier said than done. And you might even be thinking, you know, that'll never work for me, because we often believe that our pain is unique, but there's a commonality there. Yes, your story is unique and your perception of that story is valid. And what happened to you is valid, but your healing journey is going to look different because it's you. You know, however, the process doesn't change. Remember, not doing anything to change something will hold you hostage to that painful moment, that painful experience in your life, and you'll never let go. And if you do nothing about it, then nothing will change. All right, really quickly before we dive in, I just want to share a brief story with you. Obviously, I can't share too many deets, but I had a client who had a parent that just wasn't around when he was growing up. And that impacted him, you know, on how he viewed relationships, of course, and how he entered them. And, you know, but he brushed it off as if there was no connection, as if it didn't impact the way he showed up in his life, you know. But once we got underneath it and traced its roots, then he was able to give himself what he needed, you know, what was missing. And wow, the shifts in his life were long lasting and life changing. So a number of us have had absentee parents. I have. And, you know, that's not necessarily unique, right, in this day and age. But however, the way that we process and deal with them is the differentiator. Anyway, let's dive in. Have you ever felt like you've been spinning your wheels about the things in your life that you're having a hard time letting go of? I've been there, you know, more than I'd like to admit, so you're not alone. You know, we've all experienced situations that hit us so hard that we find ourselves still revisiting that situation. Sometimes with different people, right? It's like different scenes, same characters, different plot, but we're still going back there, still feeling all of those feelings. And we're like, damn, you know, why is this so hard for me to move on? Or we just have a hard time, you know, letting go of control. You know, letting go can mean different things in different areas of our lives, right? So, but we know if you don't move past that thing, whatever that thing is, you won't move forward in your life. You won't move your life forward, whether that be having a beautiful relationship, a new career, you know, a better sense of self, better friendships. I mean, you know, and insert anything that disrupts your quality of life. It ain't gonna happen. But wouldn't it be great if you learned the art of letting go? Like, how much smoother would your life be? My God, your life moves with ease and you're no longer held hostage by that thing. But most importantly, you're not held hostage by your feelings, right? What would your life look like if you moved on from that thing? And we're going to dive into that. Make sure you stay towards the end, because I'm going to share with you one of my favorite quotes that relates to this very topic. You know you need to let go, but how do you do that in a practical sense? Like, what does that even look like? You know, how do I even move through that? If letting go was easy, we wouldn't be walking around here hurting each other. On a spiritual sense, letting go is easy because we humans complicate things, okay? But for the matter of this topic, it's hard for us, especially if we haven't learned certain things, right? Especially if you've had traumatic things that happen to us. You know, letting go is not an easy process, but it's also not impossible to work through. It's something that you can learn to do. In fact, I'll be bold enough to say it's an art form. And with every art form, again, it's learnable. And believe it or not, you have the power inside of you to learn this. But with most things, it first starts with asking the right questions. You know, sometimes we're stuck in a specific area of our lives because we're not really asking the right questions, which inevitably has us focusing on either the wrong areas of our lives or it has us focusing on the wrong actions to take. If you think about when you take your car to see a mechanic, the mechanic will ask you a series of questions, right? Based on the symptoms, you know, based on what the car is doing or what it isn't doing. You know, if your car needs an oil change, the mechanic isn't gonna go straight to removing or replacing a radiator based on a hunch, right? So when it comes to assessing your own life, it's crucial to look at the symptoms by doing a fair assessment and linking it back to what's underneath or underneath the hood, for lack of a better term, right? And honestly, you learn over time how to ask the right questions when you have a better understanding of yourself. So this comes with time and experience. So don't be too hard on yourself if you're not immediately sure, you know, about what to ask. Another thing that might be harder is if you've experienced life-altering trauma. But I believe with trauma comes great wisdom that we shouldn't ignore. So it doesn't matter where you are along your journey. It's all about the willingness to change. The willingness and the readiness. That is the game changer. All right, let's get to the meat of this right here. Grab a pen and a piece of paper or a smartphone. Grab your notes and start taking down some notes because you'll need to reference these questions and use them so you can teach yourself the art of letting go. Before you can begin the process of letting go, you first need to understand the attachment. What do I mean by attachment? I had mentioned this earlier in the beginning of the video. Attachment is, what is your relationship to that thing? So here are some questions to ask yourself. What is my attachment to the thing that I'm having a hard time letting go? Like, really sit with that. You know, how does that attachment serve you? Because there are benefits to not moving on, right? If I don't move on, I don't need to feel uncomfortable. No one will hurt me, that sort of thing. That's a benefit. Ask yourself, does it make you feel safe, protected? Does it allow you to avoid uncomfortable situations? Then ask yourself, how does it not serve you? How does what you're doing right now, holding on, not serving you in the long run? So what's the long-term impact of that? And lastly, how does it disrupt your life? How does holding on to this thing get in the way of you living your life? I really want you to just sit with these because they're heavy, they're loaded questions. Evaluate the attachment deeply and take a moment to do that. And then once you answer those questions, I want you to ask these questions. So keep writing. What feelings are underneath it all? If I'm holding on to something someone did to me and I can't move forward from the situation, what is that feeling? Remember, I always say feelings are just feedback. We kind of get caught up and wrapped up in our emotions, or we don't want to feel, but feelings, they give us the answers. Another question to ask, last one, if I'm having a hard time letting go of control, what is underneath? Sit with that. Some of us are challenged here to step out of our thinking brains and get into our feeling bodies. So if I'm holding on to that situation, then the first thing to do is find the underlying feeling. Often you'll find anger as being that feeling. Then beneath the anger is hurt. Then underneath the hurt is safety. Underneath the safety is a lack of trust. And underneath all of that is a small child that didn't get a specific need met. And I'll do a video later about inner child healing at some point. So that need wasn't met, and now it's showing up in your life and disrupting everything around you and inside of you. So when we need to let go of something, we need to understand the death grip we have on that thing. You're not letting go because, rightfully so, you have no idea how to. You're not letting go because you haven't peeled back all of the essential layers. This isn't just like a 1-2 punch and you're done. We really have to feel all the way through before we can actually change the behaviors. But once we get through that feeling, we can then bring our thinking brains back and ask the following questions. So write these two questions down. When did it start? When did I find myself like really holding on tightly? And how far back did this show up in my life? Peeling back the layers in a transparent, non-judgmental way will give you the answers that you're looking for. But you have to be unafraid to peel back the layers. You have to be ready to tell yourself the truth. No matter how much it hurts, no matter how much it feels unfair, no matter the judgments that may rise to the surface, this is what gets the healing process going. Remember when I said earlier, you have to be willing and ready. If that willingness and readiness is not there, change will not happen. So now you've uncovered all of the emotions underneath. And now you're able to recognize the link between, you know, why you're holding on and why you're not moving forward. So in the next video, I'll dive a little bit deeper because I don't like to overwhelm people with too much information. So in the next video, I'm going to dive a little bit deeper on how to practice this in your everyday life. All right. So before we end, because we're at the end, I'm going to share with you my favorite quote, which I think is timely, which also leads to the next phase of the letting go video, which also leads to the next phase of the letting go process that I will do in another video. So there's this guy, his name is Carl Jung. He's one of my favorite psychoanalysts. And I feel like in grad school, low-key, we did not learn enough about him. And he has a lot of powerful information, a lot of useful information when it comes to this healing stuff. And one of the things that he said is, I am not what happened to me. I am what I choose to become. So letting go of your past hurts has everything to do with you wanting things to be different in some shape or form. Wishing it was different. And that's a natural response, right? We all like look back in our lives and like, man, you know, I wish my parents were different, or I wish I grew up in a different family, or I wish that thing didn't happen to me. However, the back and forth struggle is you wanting to change what is impossible to change. It's not about accepting the things that happened to you as if like, oh, it was okay. It has nothing to do with that. But you must find a way to accept the unchangeable circumstances. And it's not really about you forgiving, forgetting at some point, because some of us, you know, we're not really there yet to forgive, right? So knowing that this thing, whatever it was, happened to you is unchangeable. So now what are your plans for the rest of your life? Because it's all about who you are now in this moment. And I want you to sit with that. Think about that. Now I got an extra bonus for you guys. Another quote. I love quotes because quotes like literally in a moment can like shift your whole perspective. And he says, the wise man will ask himself, who am I that all this should happen to me? To find the answer to this faithful question, he will look into his own heart. We often ask ourselves like, why did this happen to me? Why did I have to go through that? And I believe that life is all about initiation. Initiation for you to develop and become the person you're supposed to become. And that's a whole nother video. I've got a whole bunch of videos for y'all. But I'll be doing more letting go videos because it's a whole ass process, guys. You know, it's not like a one-step thing. You uncover the feelings, then you need to practice it. And then whenever you need to practice something, life is going to send you ways in which for you to practice it, whether it's in a relationship, whether it's something that happened, and you're challenged to practice it. And we could shy away from that, or we can lean in into those life lessons and actually make those shifts, okay? So as I said earlier, there's a few videos that are gonna be coming out. So hit the notification button to be notified of the new videos, like, subscribe, and share. If you know somebody could receive some value from this, please share the video. And also share in the comments below, let me know. I'd love to hear from you just to get a sense of like, what are the things that you're having a hard time letting go of? Or maybe you let go of something, would love some tips. You know, share with the community about how you let go of something and how you were able to move on from that. Until next time, beautiful people, I will see y'all next time.